Identifying proportional relationships. So same idea as last lesson, but this time it's going to be determining it on a graph. So it says proportional relationships can be determined by showing equal ratios. So that's the equal fractions, or by graphing. I wish you could see that. Graphing the data. So if the graph of the two quantities is a, we're going to put on the blank here, is a straight line through the origin, then the two quantities are proportional. So a straight line through the origin, that's what you're going to have to check after you graph. So this means that the line must be straight and pass through the point. Oh yeah. Do you know what the origin is? It is the point 0, 0. All right. So let's go right to an example here. The example says the slowest mammal on Earth is the tree sloth. It moves at a speed of 6 feet per minute. Determine whether the number of feet the sloth moves is proportional to the number of minutes it moves by graphing on the coordinate plane. Explain your reasoning. Okay, so first we're going to make a table. And let's see, if he's going 6 feet every minute, right? That's what it says. Yes, 6 feet per minute here. Okay, so at 0 minutes, he has gone 0 feet. I'm gonna zoom in some more. After 1 minute, he's gone 6 feet, then 12, then 18, then 24. Now, obviously from the last lesson, we know this is proportional because if we start reducing this, these all reduce to a sixth, right? So we know it's proportional, but let's just look at, see what the graph looks like. All right, so graph and connect the ordered pairs, time and distance on the coordinate plane. Okay, whenever you have time, that should go on the x-axis, and this is minutes. So we're gonna write that in there. And on the side will be the distance. So distance, and that is feet. Okay. Oh, sorry, I was trying to fix my D. Okay. And now let's try to space it out as much as we can. So for time, we only have to get up to 4. So I'm going to start here at 0. And I'm going to skip every other one and put a number here. So here's going to be my 1. Notice I'm labeling the line, not the space, no. Label the line, not the space, no. For distance, we have to get up to 24. So could we go up by 2s? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, no. So let's go up by 3s. So 3, 6, 9, 12. And let me try to zoom in even more. Just so you can see, I'm labeling the line, not the space, no. 21, 24, 27, 30. Okay. So there's our numbers. And now we are going to graph. Now I'm using Cami here. I'm showing you because on your homework, you're going to have to graph. The way I do it is I pick a really big paintbrush for the dots. So I don't know. Let's pick 8. So the first point, 0, 0, I just put my cursor right over 0, 0, boom, put a dot. That might be too big, but that's fun. 1 minute and 6 feet. So I put my cursor right here. Boom. There's the 1 minute and 6 feet. 2 and 12. Let's line it up. Boom. 3 and 18. Try to line it up. And 4 and 24. Okay, so there's my dots. And now you can use the line tool go over here to shapes, pick line, and you might want it a little bigger here, maybe 4. And you can go and connect your points. That is a lovely, lovely graph. So the things we're supposed to check for if it's proportional, is this line straight? I would say yes, it is. There's no bends in it. Does it go through the origin? Yes, it started right at 0, 0. So we can say yes to that one also. So the idea of this lesson is if you say yes to both of those things, then you know the data is proportional. So now we have two ways to check. You can check in a table by reducing the fractions, or you can graph it and see if the line is straight and through the origin. Okay? All right, so now let's try some examples here. Practice number 1. The table shows the number of calories an athlete burned per minute of exercise. Determine whether the number of calories burned is proportional to the number of minutes by graphing on the coordinate plane. Explain your reasoning. Okay, so let's space this out again. We've got time, so this will be on the bottom here. This will be minutes. Let me go back to 2 here. So this is time. That'll be minutes. And then we've got number of calories. So number of cals. We should probably put a title. Calories burned. Could be our title. Okay, and now let's plan out our graph. Oh, we only have to get up to 3 minutes this time. I might skip every 3 then. So here's 0. I'm going to skip 1, 2. I'm going to put my 1 here. 1, 2, 2, 1, 2. Remember, you're labeling the line, not the space, no. Label the line, not the space, no. And for number of calories, we're getting up to 13. Can I go up by 1? 5, 6, 7, 8. No, I'm going to go up by 2 then. 2, 4, 6, 10, 12, 14, 16. Okay, I'm going to make my paintbrush bigger. And let's plot these points. So 0, 0. Okay, 1, 4. 2, 8. And 3, 13. Uh-oh. Out there. That's kind of high. Let's bring it down a little bit. It should be right in the middle. 3, 13. That's not bad. Okay, so now I'm going to go to my line and see if we can connect them all, starting here. Boom, boom. Oh, it's going to be a little off. So you know what? I believe there's a bend in this. So here's the first part of the line. And then I'm going to need another. There's a bend. Might be hard to tell with your ruler or whatever straight edge you're using, or but actually if we reduce these, right, this would be a 4th. Oh boy, still online. Sorry, I go back to my pencil, pen, whatever. If you reduce these, this is a 4th, that's a 4th, this one doesn't reduce to a 4th, so we should know it's not proportional. So this is a no. So we're gonna say no, this is not proportional. Because, and what are we going to say? It does start at the origin, but it's not a straight line because it has a bend in it. So we could say because the line is not straight. Okay, so that would be our work there. All right. Okay, one more. Number 2, the cost of renting video games from Games Incorporated is shown in the table. Determine whether the cost is proportional to the number of games rented by graphing on the coordinate plane. Explain your reasoning. Okay, so maybe I'll use the text bugs here. So video game, rentals. And we have number of games, and the cost. and have to draw this one. So this is cost in dollars. All right, and let's space it out. We have to get up to 4, so I'm going to go every other. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we only have to get up to 9. I think I can go by 1s this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep. So we can go by 1s. 2. Okay. And we're going to plot the points. So let's get a bigger point here. 1, 3. So 1 game is $3. 2 games is $5. 3 games is 7. Oops, I'm on the wrong spot. 3 games is $7. And 4 is 9. Okay, now let's connect just what we have here. So I'm going to start here and connect. That is looking straight to me. But it's not starting at 0, 0. So I guess this one is a no 2. So I'm going to say, no, this is not proportional because the line does not start at the origin. Okay, so if that was my picture, that would be my logic, and that is correct. Now, some people argue, and they're like, but Miss Guestwick, I'm going to go in green here. They say, if you don't have any video games, it doesn't cost anything. So they sometimes put a dot at 0, 0 if it makes sense for the problem. Hey, I wanted green. So they would say, look, it would be there, but then what would happen for them is when they did their line, watch what happens. It would go up to here. That doesn't continue straight on. So theirs would have a bend in it. So this would be okay as long as it makes sense with the problem, but they would still say no. Let's make this one green and match. Oh, don't have the bright green. Of course, well, we'll make it this green. They would still say no. There we go. And they would say this is not proportional because the line is not straight. So you have a choice. If you think that the problem would have a 0, 0, right? No games, no dollars. You could put it, but then your line wouldn't be straight. You would still say no. If you just plot what they had, you can kind of tell it's not going to hit 0, 0. Like you could even maybe, I don't know, extend this out just to see. Right? If I extended this one out, it would go... Maybe you could do dots or something. It wouldn't really hit at 0 if you extended that. So your choice, but either way, your answer for this one should be no because one of those things is not true. All right. All right. Good job, guys. Oh, one other thing on your homework. Make sure you zoom in if you have to graph. I think it really helps if you zoom way in. It'll help you kind of see the grid better. Okay, that's it. Good job.